Thank you. Honourable Member Srimati Supriya Sule.
Stand here today in support of this bill of banning the unregulated deposit scheme bill 2019. So it's really strange today to be in parliament and passing two bills which were both originally UPA bills. In the morning we passed a bill against terrorism which was originated by us, and even this bill, Mehtabji talked about it, if I please I stand corrected, but this was the bill that was, who say not at all? This bill was brought in first time in UPA 2 in the last year by Sri Chidambaram ji, you can verify it. And after that, it then went to standing committee which was headed by, after that, Sri Moili ji was the chairman of the standing committee and Honorable Manmohan Singh ji was a member of that committee. And they opposed the bill. So UPA gets some credit for it.
Please.
I know y'all were also part of it. I'm not taking it away from y'all. But the chairman matters at the end of the day. And so it's really strange and it's a good deja vu that two bills today we are passing which were initiated by the UPA. I stand here to ask a few questions. Mehtabji has actually covered most of the queries which were left out by the government, which were recommended by the standing committee. But there are a few questions I'd like to ask the Honorable Minister, the Finance Minister and the MOS, who initiated and has clarified most of the points which are required. But SEBI normally has collected money from people who have already got caught in the web. Now that money lies with SEBI, be it in Punjab, be it in Uttar Pradesh. There are several schemes pan India which are suffering and people are suffering. So I appreciate the initiative that this government has taken, but when will the depositors get the money? It's not just important to punish the person. I think we all have to walk that extra mile to make sure that the final destination is not just the punishment, but the final destination is making sure that the person who has lost the money in faith gets it. So I was just wondering that is either you go for fast track courts or you go for a waterfall mechanism in which the investor becomes the most critical person. So if we follow the waterfall mechanism, do you think this will, we can expedite this? So if you could kindly clarify, because I'll give you an example which has happened in my own state, sir. There is a company called Samruddha Jeevan. It is a 3,484 crore loss. There's a, I can't say gentleman, but a person who ran it called Mahesh Motivar. And he was arrested, if I stand corrected, in 2017. And within a few months, I don't know what circumstances, he was let out. Now when there is a 3,000 crore scam, and this government is so committed to making sure that this Ponzi scheme stops and the waterfall mechanism, if they are committed to giving it, what happened in this case? The gentleman is all over the place. He travels. He doesn't only have cases in Maharashtra. There were cases in Odisha. There were cases in Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka. So I just want a clarification specifically in this case that if a gentleman in 2017 is arrested within few months, how is he left aside? So what really is happening behind doors? Or, I mean, it all looks very suspicious. So this is a pointed question I'd like to ask the government. Second thing is the Benami properties. A lot of people have talked about it. You've got the law, we all passed it unanimously. But how are you going to reach and get these properties? So many people who take their money out of the country. So when they leave the country and they buy hotels, they are in businesses abroad, how will you repatriate that money back into India? So that, because our final destination is not just stopping, it doesn't stop there. That's just a piecemeal way of doing it. So we need to make sure that it's repatriated and given to the person who deserves it. I think the intention of the government, I'm sure, is very noble, because this is all about poor, and the whole house unanimously is supporting this bill. I would like to you to draw us a road path that will make sure the poor people who we are all fighting in one voice today get that deserving. So last two points I'd like to ask for a clarification to the government, that the list of registered deposit takers must be publicly available, because it's so strange that the other people who reach out are cooperative banks. Somehow this government is a bit hard on cooperative banks. I remember during demonetization, we had to go to court about, there were banks in Maharashtra who had some cash which was absolutely legal. RBI not once but three times came to the cooperative banks and they had to find a legal battle. Only that's when the money was exchanged. But these are banks and people who have reaches beyond imagination. At least the cooperative bank is somebody who does a good job. Ponzi scheme obviously have arms or roots which are so deep that they go where normal banks do not reach. So what is the mechanism we are going to find out to bring in more literacy amongst people and awareness not to fall? I won't just say it's greed. I think it's unfair to call it greed, because I think one of the members did say that people want to do it out of greed. I don't think everybody tries to earn money and earn a little more to make sure their children get better quality of life. So I think, is there some, but is there a way we can find that the reach that they have and bring in, because even if legislation comes in, are all, you got an ordinance. From the, first of all, I don't know what is the rush of the ordinance, and if the ordinance has come, between the ordinance and now, what have you achieved in the state? I don't see much happening in my own state. So the ordinance route may not be the right route here. And how much have you sensitized the states? Because if a police has to intervene into an investigation, he has no idea because he's not sensitized. So I would request the Honourable Minister to sensitize, walk the extra mile so that the depositor gets the money. And what is the 3,000 crore case in of Samruddhi in Maharashtra, as well as the PAN club card issue, which has nothing to do with the PAN card, but it's a PAN club card. So these two are huge losses which common man in who are depositors, who are either retired people or very poor people from the bottom of the pyramid. So I would request the Honourable Minister to intervene and make sure that every depositor deserves the money back. Thank you.
CPK Gunjari.